In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, peace be with you. To prepare our hearts to celebrate the Mass, now let us call to mind our sins. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on all of us, forgive us of sinfulness, bring each one of us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, strength of all the saints who through the cross were pleased to call the martyrs of St. Paul, Mickey, and companions to life, grant, we pray, that by their intercession we may hold with courage until death the faith that we profess. And we ask all of this through Christ our Lord.
A reading from the first book of Kings. Solomon stood before the altar of the Lord in the presence of the whole community of Israel, and stretching forth his hands toward heaven, he said, Lord, God of Israel, there is no God like you in heaven above or on earth below. You keep your covenant of mercy with your servants who are faithful to you with their whole heart. Can it indeed be that God dwells on earth? If the heavens and the highest heavens cannot contain you, how much less this temple which I have built? Look kindly on the prayer and petition of your servant, O Lord my God, and listen to the cry of supplication which I, your servant, utter before you today. May your eyes watch night and day over the temple, the place where you have decreed you have been honored. May you heed the prayer which I, your servant, offer in this place. Listen to the petitions of your servant and of your people Israel, which they offer in this place. Listen from your heavenly dwelling and grant pardon. The word of the Lord. Our responsorial psalm, how lovely is your dwelling place, Lord, mighty God. How lovely is your dwelling place, Lord, mighty God. My soul yearns and pines for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God. How lovely is your dwelling place, Lord, mighty God. Even the sparrow finds a home and the swallow a nest in which she puts her young. Your altars, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God. How lovely is your dwelling place, Lord, mighty God. Bless those who dwell in your house. Continually they praise you. O God, behold our shield, and look upon the face of your anointed. How lovely is your dwelling place, Lord, mighty God. I have rather one day in your courts than a thousand elsewhere. I have rather lie at the threshold of your house of my God than dwell in the tents of the wicked. How lovely is your dwelling place, Lord, mighty God.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. When the Pharisees and some scribes who had come from Jerusalem gathered around Jesus, they observed that some of his disciples ate their meals with unwashed hands. For the Pharisees, and in fact all Jews, do not eat without carefully washing their hands. And on coming from the marketplace, they do not eat without purifying themselves. And there are many other things that they observe. Purification of cups and jugs and kettles and beds. So why do your disciples not follow the traditions of the elders and instead eat a meal with unclean hands, they asked. And Jesus responded, well, did Isaiah prophesy about you hypocrites, as it is written, his people honor me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. In vain do they worship, teaching his doctrines, human precepts. You disregard God's commandments, but cling to human tradition. He went on to say, how well you have set aside the commandment of God in order to hold up your tradition. For Moses said, honor your father and your mother, and whoever curses father or mother shall die. Yet you say, if someone says to father or mother, any support you might have at his korban, meaning dedicated to God, you allow them to do nothing more for their father or mother. You nullify the word of God in favor of your tradition that you might have handed on. And you do many other things. The gospel of the Lord.
Thank you. Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread and wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. They will become for us our spiritual food and drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, my sisters and brother, that our sacrifice will be acceptable to God, who is our loving Creator. O Lord our God, who once established these created things to sustain us, grant, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks now to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and in every place to give you thanks, loving and eternal God, through Jesus your Son. He is the Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with hearts that are full of love, we join the angels and saints now as we say, Holy. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be here in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ will be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout our world and bring her to the fullness of love, together with Francis, our Pope, Mitchell, our bishop, all your clergy, and all of your loving, faithful people. Remember all of our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them now into the light of your face. Have mercy on all of us, we pray, with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles, St. Paul Mickey, St. Alphonsus, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. May we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil and grant peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin. Protect us from fear and worry as we wait in joyful hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and grant to all of us the peace and the unity of your kingdom, where you live as Lord forever and ever. May the peace of the Lord Jesus be always with you. Share a sign. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. We remember those who are homebound and unable to be with us, for whatever particular reasons, who might be watching us now, and we pray, my Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least now spiritually into my heart. I embrace you, for you are already there, and I unite myself to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Everybody standing up. I was this weekend, I was over in north of Kansas City in a farming community speaking there, and for the weekend. And so at Mass, it was time for the Our Father. And so the servers came over to me. Two little girls that were serving, you know, they came over to me for the Our Father. And the one tapped me and said, "You're supposed to hold my hand." And I said, "Well, what if I don't want to?" And she said, "I don't want to either." But she says, "That's what we're supposed to do." I said, "Okay." Honest to God. Out of the mouth of babes. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you and all your loved ones, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and each other.